First of all, I wanted to say I'm sorry about my hair. I kept it this way because I'm going to show you today how I make my curls, the ones that a lot of you have been wondering about. And it's gonna be in the end of the video. And I wanted to do just a little update to let you know what's happening. I will start with the very beginning. I have been really struggling with some equipment lately, and I know that I'm obviously not the only one with this problem. And I have a lot of noise from upstairs from my neighbors, and my equipment picks up everything that happens upstairs, and it was really making me frustrated and anxious, and I was getting so angry because I couldn't do what I like to do, you know. And I was almost looking into renting space to actually do my videos in, and I obviously cannot afford it, so after about 2 weeks of just worrying about it and being angry at my neighbors constantly, I decided to listen to great advice that I'm sure most of you know, and that is that there are two types of worry. First one, the one that you have no power preventing or fixing, and that means that you should not worry about something that you have no control over. Worry number two is the one that you can fix, or that you can do something to fix, to get it out of your system. So I decided to be strong, and I decided to fix my problems. Why I'm saying it is that I hope that some of you will hear me, and maybe think about this saying yourself. I worry so much about things that I'm not supposed to worry about. I am a perfectionist as well. And when things are going out of my way, it's unacceptable for me. But these past 2 weeks, I was, I guess, not myself because I let the worry get the best of me. And sorry about the cricket. Basically, what I'm saying, if you have some kind of a situation that, you know, you can control, or you know you can fix, or do something in order for it to go away, to stop your worry, you should get up and do something about it. So what I did is I started researching soundproofing, and I have this office space which works as my boyfriend's gym and my studio, kind of. It's the quietest room I have in the house, and I have my little corner here. So what I decided to do is to research how to soundproof the room DIY. Meaning do it yourself. Because I looked into professional setups, and unfortunately, I don't have that kind of money. So I started with hanging some thick comforters on the wall. I don't have anything on this one yet, but I have on the other walls. And I will finish it up, obviously, and I'm hoping that it will kill the echo a little bit. Then I looked into soundproofing the ceiling, and I have thing that I found is two options. The first one was that I would buy a special soundproof ceiling tent. I'm only saying this to hopefully inspire some of you to deal with the things that worry you. And if it was very cheap out, the way out for me, first of all, the blankets, if you go to a thrift shop, they're almost inexpensive used blankets. Of course they have to be thicker type, like quilted or comforters. So anyway, so I did that. And I decided to go through my videos and test out my microphones. And I've came to realization that my microphones are horrible. I actually think that my microphones are the worst in the whole community. And it's a real shame. Because I feel like you deserve so much better. I've seen, I sold it. And I'm buying new, more practical and less expensive furniture. So I've been doing that for a while. Then I wanted to tell you something, and that is that I am going to school. I don't think I will have time for any of this anymore. past, promise. But if it will get in the way of my school, I will not be able to keep up with it. However, so I've been trying to get into school for the past, you know, few months as well. That's why I was kind of, you know, a little bit away. What else? Well, I went to Russia. a whisper video and put it on YouTube. What would happen? What would people say? If she asked the wrong person, what would happen? Who would be there? The whole whisper community might never have discovered itself without it. Have you ever thought about that? Anybody who has created who have been interested in how I do my hair. I have a little notebook. By the way, I'll do a notebook collection video soon. I hope you like it. This one has a little strap on. In the video, that I most of the time have some same type of curls that I do them with. I'm gonna write it to you. It is gold and easy bun. Google it, you will find it. Okay. So how do I do my hair? I rarely use heat. If I do, I have a certain technique that I use, and I will show it to you in one of the videos sometime. Like those curls that you've seen in origami video. And then I have another technique of curling, making small little curls, like waves, that you've seen in Sassy Maria video. Those are two other types that I do, and I will make those later for you, if you don't mind. Now this one, I have a mirror here again, is just a bun. I usually just sleep with it on, usually. If you even will have it for 20 minutes after you just dried your hair and you put it in hot air or hot hair, you should curl it just a little bit and it will give you volume. So, how I do it. I slept with this on for about 8 hours since I've been sleeping this on. Let's see. It got stuck there, sorry. Of course it broke. Anyway. Let me just break it apart a little bit for you. Mine's of course, I need to wait for it to settle down a little bit. To kind of make its way. But this is usually what I use. But my curls, some days, if I put some kind of volumizer, or like a mousse, or a curling spray in my hair, before I put it in the bun, they will hold better and you will have much bigger curls. So. with some brush strokes. Sorry. With a big brush like this. I forgot to tell you. So, as far as microphones, they will arrive soon. And I will test them out. For you. Thank you.